Belinda Audio presents the unabridged recording of Hocus Pocus versus the Stinky Pong, written by Laura Milligan and read by Marianne Fay. The dedication reads, "To my father, Spike Milligan, for all the wizzle pops, magic and laughter." Chapter 1. The Wizzles. Once upon a time, 12 magical animal-shaped islands drifted over the globe. Each one was inhabited by loony wizards and witches called wizzles. These fun-loving folk spent their days conjuring up crazy spells. Humans would probably call wizzles mad. But they were always happy and never had wars. They made and broke rules to fit in with their busy lives. As long as they didn't hurt anybody, who cared? The longest island was Sausage Dog Island. The wizzles there were sausage mad. They built mud sausage castles and cottages. Inside, they had sausage-shaped baths, taps and loos. Everything was shaped like a sausage. They wore sausage shoes and flew on sausage-shaped broomsticks. But the strange thing was that nobody ate sausages. In fact, wizzles are vegetarians. The wizzles on Sheep Island were nuts about wool. They had knitted houses and toothbrushes, even knitted broomsticks. At school, they made woolly bread and learned how to eat on all fours. Zebra Island had zebra crossings in the strangest places, from the fridge to the kitchen table, and from the table to the sink, plus one huge long zebra crossing from the front door to school. Pig Island was a huge sloppy mess. Every wizzle had to roll in pig swill before breakfast. Young wizzles made sure their clothes were covered in muck before they went to school, or they would be sent home to grub up. At school, students learned to snort like a pig and dance the pig trot. On Reindeer Island, the wizzles had built a snow machine on top of the reindeer's bulbous red nose. Hundreds of wizzles in Santa suits raced around inside, making white chocolate snowflakes. You could visit any time of year and have Christmas Day. The other islands were Lion Island, Monkey Island, Rat Island, Spider Island, Rabbit Island, and Turtle Island. Each had its own peculiar wizzle habits. But our tale begins on the largest island, the elephant-shaped island called Hocus Pocus. It was where the grand old Wizard Old Papa lived. Wizard Old Papa was the head of all the islands and was greatly loved by the wizzles. He decided to make his home on Hocus Pocus because elephants never forget, which was rather funny because Wizard Old Papa forgot a lot. The wizzles on Hocus Pocus spent their days conjuring up hilariously silly spells. One old wizard conjured up a spell that made your bottom fall off if you played with your belly button. Another produced a soap that made you shrink every time you washed. This caused a few problems when a baby wizzle disappeared down a plug hole. Another wizzle made clothes that would disappear after an hour. This impish witch made the band's capes and trousers for the summer parade. As the band marched past the town's main square, their clothes gradually disappeared, until lots of hairy pink bottoms got their first touch of sunlight. Wizard Old Papa was watching from the library balcony. He laughed non-stop for 5 days. It must be said that wizzles thought bottoms and the sounds that came out of them were the funniest things. They thought nothing of letting one rip in a public place. They called them wizzle pops, and wizzle pops made everyone laugh. The wizzles on Hocus Pocus were famous for their sweet-smelling wizzle pops. Once a day, they had a wizzle pop competition in the town square. Wizzles were invited to demonstrate their wizzle pops on the podium, and everyone who entered got a trophy shaped like a bottom. The wizzles thought this was a wonderful idea, as nobody lost and everyone was happy. Every wizzle on the island had at least half a dozen trophies, proclaiming them the number one wizzle popper. Chapter 2. Giant Golden Bums. As well as being home to the Wizzles, Hocus Pocus was home to a group of gentle one-eyed giants. It was the only island big enough to accommodate these kind-hearted creatures. Many years ago, pirates prowling the uncharted seas had captured the giants. They stole the giants' enormous socks and trousers and made them into gigantic tents, which they sold for lots of money. The Wizzles laughed at the pirates, but the giants were really fed up with losing their trousers and socks. So one day, the Wizzles on Hocus Pocus asked the giants to come and live with them. It took the Wizzles and the giants a little time to understand each other's differences. Wizzles are very curious creatures, and a rumour spread across the island that the giants had golden bottoms encrusted with jewels. Everywhere the giants went, groups of Wizzles on broomsticks flew around their trousers and tried to pull them down. The giants got upset, until Wizard Old Popper explained that the Wizzles only wanted to know if they actually had golden bottoms. The giants thought this was hilarious. They pulled down their trousers and proudly showed the Wizzles that their bottoms were the same as theirs, only much larger. After that, the Wizzles and giants talked about their differences. Some students at the Hocus Pocus school wanted to know if it was true that giants had silver snot. A giant went to their classroom and blew a massive slimy green bogey into a small cauldron. Everyone was quickly satisfied that giants had the same green snot as their own, except that giant snot came in huge soccer ball-sized lumps. The Wizzles and giants learned to respect each other, and Hocus Pocus became an even more wonderful place to live. The Wizzles realised that giants were beautiful, simple creatures who were extremely sensitive and prone to crying easily. The following list may help you understand what Wizzles have learnt about giants. 1. They were very sensitive to the feelings of others. For example, they cried whenever they saw carrots being boiled. 2. They cried frequently, even when they were happy, which was most of the time. 3. They had only one eye and one big tooth. 4. They spent lots of time caring for small insects. They had very nimble fingers. This came in handy for spider splints and wing repairs. 5. They were vegetarian nearly all the time. However, they sometimes ate bacon. 6. They had a strange habit of asking you to ask them a question when they wanted to tell you something. This could be annoying at times, but you soon got used to it. 7. They were kind and loved to help, so young Wizzles had to be careful not to take advantage of their good nature. For example, by getting them to tidy up their rooms every day. 8. They were afraid of the dark, so they slept with the light on. 9. They had 11 hearts, one in their belly button and one in each fingertip. 10. Their brains were in their left kneecap. 11. They could not produce sweet-smelling wizzle-pops, only huge, smelly, eggy ones like humans. Therefore, they were not allowed to participate in the Hocus Pocus wizzle-pop competitions. The size and smell of a single giant's wizzle-pop could blow small Wizzles hundreds of kilometres out to sea. This had happened on a few occasions, but luckily these Wizzles had been rescued and returned safely to their island homes. Chapter 3. Young Witch Lucy. Young Witch Lucy was born on Hocus Pocus. She lived with her mother, Witch Rose, and her grandmother, Granny Muddles, in a white musk stick cottage on top of the elephant's ear. The cottage was covered in tiny elephant-shaped fairy lights and surrounded by huge singing sunflowers. These meant a lot to Lucy, as they'd been planted by her father, Wizard Awol, many years before. From the cottage, you could see the entrance to the enchanted forest. It wove down the elephant's trunk and overflowed with magical delights, like chocolate-coated orange trees and bubblegum flowers. It was also where the raspberry-blowing mushrooms grew. Every time a wizard walked past, the mushrooms blew huge raspberries that smelt like raspberries. Whenever it happened to Lucy and her best friend Jo, they would roll around on the mossy forest floor, laughing uncontrollably. Like all Wizzles, Lucy and Jo spent a lot of time laughing. They'd been taught at the Hocus Pocus School of Magic that anything that made you laugh was good, as long as you weren't poking fun at others. Running through the middle of the enchanted forest was the incredible giggling stream. Wizzles gathered daily on its mossy banks to swim in the magical waters. Mischievous bubbles would chase the swimmer through the water, burst on contact, and tickle till you piddled. The forest was also home to bouncing wizzle-popping bunnies. They were born from the hopping tree, which produced eggs in its branches. On the seventh day of the seventh month, the eggs would drop. 7 minutes later, hundreds of tiny, different coloured bunnies would burst from the eggs and roll around on their tubby little bodies. During their first week of life, the bunnies released tiny wizzle pops and bounced just a few baby centimetres. But as the weeks went by, they grew stronger until they could propel themselves with massive, explosive wizzle pops. By the time they were 7 weeks old, the bunnies were fully grown mini acrobats, able to do triple somersaults over tall trees with ease. The louder the wizzle pops, the higher the bounce. Lucy could see and hear the bunnies flying over the trees from her kitchen window. The sight often caused her to choke with laughter on her cereal. Everything in Lucy's life was perfect, except that something was missing. Her father, Wizard AWOL. Wizard AWOL had built the cottage 11 years earlier for his pregnant wife, Rose. He wanted his unborn child to be able to see the hilarious bouncing bunnies from her cradle. 7 days after Lucy was born, Wizard AWOL went to Wink Street on his broomstick to buy pink baby booties and a loaf of fairy bread. He never returned. His broomstick was found broken and crushed in a laneway not far from their cottage. A single pink baby booty and a slice of squashed fairy bread lay close by. Lucy kept the booty in an old slipper next to her bed. She felt a special connection to her father whenever she held it. It was her most precious possession. Since the day Wizard AWOL disappeared, Granny Muddles, Witch Rose and Lucy had not given up hope that one day he would return. His favourite flashing carrot slippers and bunny pyjamas were still waiting for him by the fireplace. Chapter 4. It Wasn't Me. Every morning, Lucy put on her white pointed hat and her cape, ate her gobble-wobble cereal and watched the bouncing bunnies through her kitchen window. Then she kissed her mother and Kiki the cat goodbye and headed off to the Hocus Pocus School of Magic. At the Wink Street Bridge, Lucy met up with her best friend Jo. Lucy and Jo loved going to school, where they were taught lots of loony magic and crazy spells. The school was all about having fun while you learned. One week, they were taught how to turn elephant dung into delicious creamy chocolate. Jo turned up to school with two buckets overflowing with dung. The rest of the class only brought small handfuls each. So the cookery teacher, Witch Crumpet, asked Jo to place most of his dung on the school vegetable patch. On the morning of our tale, Lucy and Jo arrived at school eager for the day's magic lessons. But first, they had to attend assembly in the Great Gothic Hall. 12 stained glass windows lined the hall, and each was shaped like an animal to represent one of the Wizzle Islands. The sausage dog window was so long, it stretched down the entire length of one wall. Lucy stared at the elephant-shaped window. Like always, she wondered about the small turnip-shaped hole near the elephant's bottom. There was no brightly coloured glass in the hole, just a small post-it note that read, "Wish you were here." Lucy had often asked her famous grandfather, Wizard Old Popper, about the hole, but he always made up silly excuses. Once, he told Lucy it was where he kept a clean pair of socks. Another time, he told her it was where he kept his false teeth. Wizard Old Popper was the ruler of the 12 Wizzle Islands. He was also the principal of the Hocus Pocus School of Magic. The young Wizzles loved their school principal, famous for his ridiculous clothing. He had a habit of wearing his long cape back to front, revealing his colourful underpants. Each morning, the young Wizzles would try to guess what pair of undies he'd wizzle pop in that day. Fluffy white with purple sequins or black with gold stars. The previous week, he'd shocked the whole school by turning up in a pair of invisible undies. Wizard Old Popper's School of Magic was so popular, he had 100% attendance rate. He was always thinking up crazy ways to keep the young Wizzles happy. But the school still had rules, happy rules. They went something like this. 1. No one had to come to school. Yet all the Wizzle children came because it was so much fun. 2. Wizzle students didn't have to sit at their desks if their legs wanted to run and jump. They could go outside and run around on the circle of magic grass until their legs were tired and worn out. 3. Everyone was expected to have a good belly laugh before and after each lesson. If you failed to have a good giggle, you were sent to Wizard Old Popper.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.